what is the need of commutator segment in DC generator? So for that, let me tell you, whenever you try to induce EMF through rotating machine, right, it always produce AC waveforms, AC voltage. But here in this simulation, here in this animation, you can see that it produces DC voltages. So how did it do that? That is the fundamental question. The answer to that question is commutator segment. And in this video, we are going to learn that thing using simulation. So without wasting time, let's jump to the video. So let me introduce our assembly. Here we have two poles, N pole and S pole. This A, B, C, D, these are the conductors. We'll assume that this is a rotor. Here we have two slip rings, and with that slip rings we have brush assembly, and with that we have connected one load. So we'll understand what happens if there is no commutator and what will happen if there is a commutator. So now let's understand this thing. We have N pole and S pole. So the magnetic field we are getting is from N to S. And in this magnetic field, if we assume that our rotor is rotating in clockwise direction. So from these two arrangements, we can say that EMF induces into these conductors and current starts flowing. So the direction of current will be from A to B. Using same principle, the direction of induced EMF in this conductor will be C to D. So from this thing, we can say that current flows from G to H, A, B, C, D, E, F, right? So this will be the direction of current when it flows through the load. So if we assume this direction as a positive direction, right? So we can draw the output voltage waveform like this. So we can call it as a positive waveform. Now let's see, if we rotate this conductor, right? It shifted 180 degree, so AB is on this side and CD is on another side. Now let's see, the magnetic field, the direction of magnetic field is still the same, but the direction of A to B is now downward direction. Initially it was upward, so from this, now it's going downward side. So in the same magnetic field, when the conductor is moving downward side, the direction of induced EMF reverses. And though the direction of current flows also reverses. So now we are getting the direction of current is B to A. And in this, it is C to D. So if we see, the direction of current is this in load. Previously the direction of current was this. But now the direction of current reverses. So according to the previously assumed direction, this current could be assumed as negative current, right? So we can represent this thing as negative voltage across the load. So when the conductor is on this side, it gives positive voltage and positive current. And when it rotates 180 degree and comes to this side, it produces negative voltage and negative current. And this happens in rotating machine. But in DC machine, we do not want that negative section. And to solve these things, they are using a commutator segment. So now let me replace this slip ring assembly with commutator segment. So just replace this thing with commutator segment. And we can see that here we have a commutator segment. Basically, this commutator segment rotates with rotor, and the brush assembly stay still with the stator. Basically, assume that this is our assume this thing as our commutator segment, and this one is our brush. So commutator keeps rotating, but brush stays standstill, right? And it will extract current from the rotating part. Now let's understand what happens here. Magnetic field is N to S. The direction of rotation is in clockwise direction. So because of these two arrangements, currents we are getting is from A to B and C to D into these conductors. And according to this, we can say that current flows through the load is in this direction from F to G, right? So as per this, we can say that output voltage is in positive direction. Now let's rotate this conductor. So with this conductor, you have seen that commutator segment is also rotating. So after 180 degree, the direction of current is reversed. Now the direction of current is B to A and D to C. So over here, when the direction of current is B to A and it is C to D, you can see from here, still the current flows in the same direction to the load, right? Previously, the direction of current reverses after 180 degree, but here, because of using this commutator segment, the direction of current flows through the load and voltage across the load will remain in the same direction. It does not alter its direction. And so from this, let's observe the output voltage, it again in the positive direction, right? Positive manner. If we again rotate this rotor, it will be in initial position. We'll get again the same waveform. If we rotate it further, we'll get the same output, right? So the rotor keeps on rotating, but the output voltage is always in one direction. So what happens here? Before discussing that thing, I would like to tell you that using the same animation, I have explained how DC generator works. And if you want to watch that video, I'll provide the link in description box below. You will check out that video later on, right? I have prepared video on construction of DC generator, and even I have provided laboratory experiment on DC generators and on DC motors. So you can check out those videos later on. The link of that video will be in description box below. So now let's discuss commutator segment. Over here you can see there are four brush, and this rotating segment is known as commutator. So you can observe from this animation that only one direction, current flows in only one direction. These two commutators are known as positive commutators, and these two commutators are known as negative commutators. In positive commutators, current always go in outward direction, and in negative commutators, current always comes in opposite direction. So this is why commutator is used in DC generator, because if you remove that commutator segment, it will give you alternating current in output side, alternating quantity in output side. So it is the commutator segment which makes this rotating machine instead of AC a DC machine. So this is the commutator segment. Because of this commutator segment, we are having DC generator. So thanks to this commutator segment. And in next video, we'll meet with different types of generator, its equivalent circuit, its simplified form, and equations of all those generators. That equations will be useful to solve various numericals. So see you all in next video. So until we meet again in our next video, till the time, bye bye.